Have you ever tried to fit an elephant into a car? They don't fit, right? Well, if you follow my video, I'll show you how I made an i7 Ivy Bridge CPU and an NVIDIA GTX 1060 full-size graphics card fit into a Dodge Pack 64 case. Welcome to BitSplits. My name is Luca and this rather long video is about an hardware upgrade of a Dodge Pack 64 portable computer. There have been several attempts to upgrade the Dodge Pack 64s in the past, but most failed. They ended with an unfinished work and the Dodge Pack aesthetic completely messed up. We start from a list of needed parts. I provided the full list and some links down below if you are interested. First of all, we need a Dodge Pack 64, possibly broken, since we are going to replace all the electronics. Mine came from American Electronic Components Incorporated Company. It had a missing keycap and a broken LCD screen. Then we need an AxiomTech SHB120 PKMG 1.3 full-size CPU card that I got from René Backman Hardware Shop in Deutschland. An EIE Integration Corporation PKMG 1.3 passive backplane model PE562 that I got from Mouser.com. An i7-3770T Ivy Bridge low-power CPU, 16 GB of RAM, an NT6867-6.2A HDMI DVI video LCD controller board that I got from eBay with cables to drive a 12-inch Kimei G121X1L04 LCD screen display with a resolution of 1024x768 pixels. An Asus GeForce GTX 1060 Turbo graphics card, an HDMI flat cable, a Silverstone SFX 450W power supply to replace the electronics in the original one. Check my other video for the details of upgrading the Dodge power supply to ATX standard. I'll leave a link down below. An LG internal slim DVD reader-writer drive, a 500 GB SSD drive, a couple of Visaton miniature speakers, and a bunch of other parts. We start by removing the original internal fan from the chassis and replacing it with a new silent one. If you don't know how to completely tear down a Dodge Pack 64, you can check my other video by clicking on the link I provided down below. I replaced the original fan with a jellied Silent 6 with controlled speed. The original Dodge Pack 64 has no provisions for any kind of audio, so I had to find a place to glue two little speakers and connect them to the 68676 board audio amplifier using a hot gun and hot glue. These are the only two places where a couple of speakers can be placed. The LCD display is mounted on a steel frame that bolts directly to the aluminum chassis. I replaced the original broken display with a 12-inch Kimei model G121X1 L04 with some crafting, since the mounting holes differ. Be sure to have an LVDS cable capable of correctly driving the display at 16 million of colors, since there are many that don't. The display driver board comes with a remote for brightness and volume control, so here I'm fixing the infrared sensor to the frame with hot glue again. The original Dodge Pack 64 has a protective transparent film under the motherboard to avoid accidental shorts with the aluminium frame. I kept it, adding some more holes to accommodate for the mods. The LCD drive board is mounted next, caring to have all the cables routed accordingly. Before installing the motherboard, the backplane is tested for mechanical interference. This HDMI flat cable is necessary to connect the graphics card to the LCD driver board. This is a special cable that I got from Amazon. Here I'm routing it from the inside to the external side of the case. To let the cable pass out to the side, I modified the standard back panel bracket, cutting a small slot with a Dremel tool, and I added a system reset button and a microphone plus audio connectors. After the interference checks, we are back to the final assembly of the motherboard. The motherboard must be assembled all together with the backplane prior to the final assembly to avoid mechanical stress to the main backplane slot. some cable management is needed to avoid a messy setup. Power supply cable must be connected at this stage, while no other parts are blocking the access. This is the frame holding the floppy disk drive, the hard disk drive, and the CD-ROM drive that, again, must be prepared before assembly. The frame is held in place by only 3 screws. Checking floppy disk drive connections and cables clearance. The power supply comes in. It's a tight fit, but it fits. And it's not the elephant yet. Now, tightening cables, since this is still a portable computer and preparing to accommodate for the elephant. Here comes the elephant. This graphics card does not originally fit this configuration, but with a small modification to the CD drive, it fits to the millimeter. Why not using a shorter card? I let you figure it out. There's a specific reason. The AxiomTech motherboard allows to retain all the original DodgePack functionality, so the original parallel port and serial port bracket is connected also to the motherboard. Now that all the elephants are finally stuffed inside, it's time to close the doors. We are at the end of this video. Stay tuned for the final DodgePack 64 presentation video, and if you enjoyed it, leave a like down below and don't forget to subscribe for more BitSplits. Ciao ciao!